I've struggled with obesity my whole life. The first time I remember a kid at school made fun of me in second grade, and I thought, wow, I must be different or unacceptable in some way, you know? The less self-esteem I had, the more I would turn to food to treat how I felt. After I moved to Texas and I'd met Jeff, we were engaged. I had recently started trying to lose weight and eat healthy. I kind of changed my lifestyle and changed my nutrition around quite a bit and lost 60 pounds. And right after we got married, I knew something was wrong because I started feeling some tingling in my fingers, some tingling in my toes, but I thought I'd been traveling a lot for work. I'd been flying on airplanes a lot. And I thought maybe I'm just run down. But I went to the doctor for something totally unrelated. They happened to check my blood sugar and it wouldn't register. After that, I had additional testing and also found out that I had type 1 diabetes. There really wasn't any nutritional counseling or counseling about diabetes. It was, you need to be on insulin immediately. And so no one told me that when you get on insulin therapy, you pretty much have to change every other aspect of your life or you will gain weight. Within about 3 months, I gained back all 60 pounds. And then by the end of the first year, I was over 300 pounds. I'm somewhere between type 1 and type 2 diabetes. I feel like the obesity kind of caused some insulin resistance issues, but I also had some pancreas damage, which made me produce less insulin. Doctors are really great at treating your symptoms and treating your numbers, but they don't talk to you about how you feel. So it was always, you need to eat better, manage your diabetes better, you need to lose weight. And all these things just felt, you know, too big. It felt too big to tackle. For a lot of years, I just tried to ignore it and act like it wasn't there. I just tried to manipulate my weight with not eating, not taking my medication, not taking the insulin. I didn't exercise at all. When you don't feel comfortable in your own skin, the thought of going into a gym and, you know, jumping around or being physical, it's not the most comfortable thing. We found out we were pregnant with Ava, and I really buckled down at that point. I mean, I knew that having a healthy baby relied on my ability to stick to it. And then after we had her, she was, of course, perfectly healthy. And as she got older, I just saw how much she loved moving her body. And it kind of helped me reconnect. And I thought, man, I remember being a really physical kid. I loved sports. I loved being outdoors and doing things with my body. And I missed that. And I thought, you know, I don't want her to remember me as the mom that can't fit in the booth at the restaurant. I don't want her to remember me as the mom that can't fit in an airplane seat. I want her to remember me as a strong, capable mother. Like, that's what I want her to know. Yeah. Jeez. November of 2015, I called and made an appointment to talk with Coach Callie, and I was absolutely terrified.
I think she was a little intimidated by the idea of what it was and where her strengths or her abilities were just starting. So she wanted something new, and it was kind of a tiptoe into the doors. But little by little, that just she got more and more comfortable.
She didn't really even let this be a roadblock for her because we saw her progress just like we would see anybody progress with or without the illness that she was dealing with.
When you hit new PRs or you're able to run a mile without dying, I mean, you feel better, definitely. But I think I noticed it was good for my soul before I noticed that it was good for my health. I had a lot of wellness issues that I needed to tackle. A lot of negative self-talk, a lot of just not feeling good enough. Not feeling worthy to take care of myself. Having people who believe in you more than you believe in yourself goes a long way in helping you believe you can do anything.
Seeing her change in the aspect where she walks into the gym standing tall, I think she's really proud of herself for the first time.
Changing my lifestyle has definitely meant that my husband and daughter have had to change their lifestyles a bit as well. We both meal prep for the week, so that's been a big change for us. In the past, it was just a lot of eating out, restaurants. We do a lot more activities than we used to. It's been really cool to bond with Ava over CrossFit Kids. Sometimes we do little workouts in our garage together. I want her to always be confident in herself and her abilities and not to doubt herself. And I want her to understand that proper nutrition, moving your body, is a way of loving yourself. Normal range for your A1C, which is your 3-month average, for a diabetic person should be 7 or less, and I was only at 7.4, and that's being absolutely no medication, no insulin, no nothing. This is the first time that I've ever had doctors look at me and say, keep doing what you're doing.
You did good. Good job, man.
I think diabetes kind of loomed large because it felt like I was already defeated when I started, but I realize now diabetes is a real condition, but the obstacle that I thought I was facing that I couldn't beat, that doesn't exist. What I can do and what is in my control is just to make one good decision at a time. There's a lot of value in just moving your body and putting the right fuel in it.
I think that CrossFit, if you embody it like it's supposed to be embodied, you are encompassing all aspects of your overall health and wellness. What we do in our communities is so powerful in that we're able to change lives in our little bitty box, which is super awesome to see.